Hello and welcome back to the channel. My name is Hyginus, okay, and in today's video I'm sharing 5 AI features which I use in Figma. The last one on the list will shock you. Make sure you watch this video to the end. Like, share, subscribe, and maybe give me a thanks. That way you're supporting me to create more content on this channel. So to be able to use the AI features, you need to have the educational plan or you need to have the paid plan feature on Figma. Either of these two will give you access to the AI features, which I'm going to talk about in this video. Then the next thing you need to do, you need to update your Figma to the latest Figma version. Let me quickly show you how to do that on Figma. So you need to go to the top of your Figma, click on the Figma, and then click on check for updates. So you need to have the latest update of Figma for you to be able to have access to these AI features. So you could see I've already updated my Figma and I have the latest features. And that is why I'm able to use the AI features, which I'm going to be talking about in this video. For you to be able to access the AI features, you hit Command K on your keyboard or Control K on your keyboard, depending on the Windows you're using. So right now I'm using a Mac, so I'll just use Command K to access these AI features. So right here we have the different section for our AI. The first section here is the recent section. So here you get to see the recent AI features which you have used. The next one is the image editing section, mainly for manipulating images. And the next section we have the design tool, mainly for designing in Figma. And the last one is the riffing and the writing tool, mainly for writing content on Figma. So number one on my list is on the image editing section. I use the remove background AI feature a lot in my Figma design. Let me show you how this really works on Figma. So as a UI UX designer or a digital designer, image is something you must play around always with. And one of the things you do with your image is to remove background images. And I remember using tools like remove.bg that usually has to be paid for you to remove images. Sometimes I even remember creating different accounts on remove.bg just to be able to have access to the free option of removing some backgrounds for my images. So I'd like to remove the background of this image to show you guys how this works. So what I can do, there are ways I can go around this. You can easily just click on the image here, and then you could see this AI icon here, or you could click on this AI icon right here. And when you click on this, you can see remove background. Another way to go around it is to use your Command K, which I showed you guys earlier. It brings up this, and because I'm selecting this image, there are suggestions to what the AI can do for this particular layer which I have selected. So what I can do is I can look at the options which the AI has given me. I can click on remove background, and it will take some time, probably less than a few seconds, to remove the background depending on how strong your internet is. And this is really fast. The background has been removed. Wow, this looks really nice. You could see the details of the editing, very, very perfect. This AI feature is mind-blowing on Figma. So the number two on my list is the replace content. I use this a lot in Figma to replace copies of my design. I remember back then as a designer where we used Lorem Ipsum. When we create designs, because our clients have not given us realistic content, we use the Lorem Ipsum to like place as a placeholders for our content. And sometimes clients usually find it very difficult to really understand what the content is meant for. And we find ourselves explaining, oh, this should be about your content and not the Lorem Ipsum. So Figma has created this AI tool. I won't even take Figma for that. We can easily just put realistic content. I'm a big fan of always preaching use realistic content. So you could just use realistic content through the AI to kind of just replace copies of your content. I'll show you how this really works on Figma. So let's jump into Figma. So right here on the about page, I have this about me section. Right now I'm using Lorem Ipsum to kind of fill up this text, and I'm going to use the AI feature to kind of get a realistic content of about me. And one of the interesting things is that the AI is going to look at this whole page and really understand what content should be here and eventually find a very realistic content to fill here. So what I can do is to use the AI feature, select this and click on the actions here. I need to give you suggestions, which is the replace content. I'm going to click on it and then fill in this. I can see I can use the tab. The tab will get the text, fill in realistic content. I can say with, let's say, 2 paragraphs. With 2 paragraphs and 5 lines each. So the AI will quickly just go through what you have written, and you see very interesting content. I'm a product designer with over 5 years of experience in the tech industry. I specialize in creating user-centered designs that are both visually appealing and highly functional. And I think this is really, really cool. Helps us to create content as fast as possible rather than using the Laurel Ipsum. And to be honest, the speed at which this was done is really, really amazing and very interesting. So my third on the list is on the riffing and writing section of the AI tools. This is very interesting. I'm going to use the translate tool feature on the AI. I can remember back then using ChatGPT to translate from English to maybe French. Maybe I've told the clients that I know how to read and write French, which I don't know, but I try to use AI features that can help me translate those texts into French. Now, Figma has given us the hack to actually get this done on Figma as fast as possible. And you can go ahead and tell your client that you know how to speak Spanish, Arabic, whatever language, and then you could make designs that have those writings and your clients will be wow. Let me quickly show you how to do this on Figma. Now, looking at this case study page, I want to change all the copies on this page to French. Now, maybe this client wants a design that also speaks French or communicates to the audience in French. So what I can easily do is to just select the whole page and click on this action tool as well. And you could see suggestion, which the AI tools will give you. So one of the suggestions I want to use is the translate tool. So once I click translate tool, it gives me lots of options to use. One of the options is the Chinese. You could use the traditional Chinese. You could use the simplified Chinese. You could see Dutch. You could see English in United Kingdom and United States. You could choose French, and which is the one I told my clients that I know how to do. So I'm just going to select French and just allow AI to do its thing. And you could see AI changing every copies of the text to French. And this is very mind-blowing. You could see all the copies of this page changed to French. How does AI know how to do all of this thing? This is very mind-blowing. At this point, if you're really enjoying this video, don't forget to like, share, comment, subscribe, and even maybe buy me a thanks. That is one way you're showing me that you're really enjoying this video and then you are supporting me to create more content like this. Now let's look at the fourth on the list, which is the rename layers. So one of the standards in design industry is to name each layers in your design. And sometimes when I look at designs from other designers and I see things like frame one, group one, and all of that, I feel like that designer is a novice. Because the essence of renaming every layers is not just for naming convention's sake, it's to help engineers and developers understand each functional layers in your design. And this is what Figma has helped us to do. You can easily rename your layers with the AI tool. Let me show you how this works on Figma. So looking at this design, you could see that the layers here, let's look at the layers panel. You could see things like frame 79, frame 34. This is so annoying to get to see designs like this. You don't really explain what this is. You want to tell us this is a future image for this case study and all of that. So you are supposed to rename each. You want to tell us that this is a button. I think this was renamed properly. This is a button and all of that. So how do you rename all these layers using the AI feature? What I can do is, let me quickly take this back to the English version using the Control Z. And let's see if we're going to go back to the English version. Yeah, we're back to the English version. And I want to rename these layers, right? So I'll just click on the AI feature right here and then look at the suggestions. One of the suggestions is rename layers. So I just click on it and I'll wait for the AI to do its thing. So it's very fast. You could see how fast it is renaming each of these layers. You could see that it's renaming each of these layers with the right wordings so that our engineers and developers will be able to understand each of the whole layers that we have added on this case study design. And you can see it's done. Let's look at what he has done. So you see this, he has identified this to be an image, which is a very good thing to do. You could go ahead and say, okay, this is a future image, but the AI tool has helped you to identify that this is an image. Let's look at this. This is a project overview. Really great. So one thing that the AI do is, it's very smart to understand the whole structure of the page and know what to rename each of the layers to. So this is project overview. We have the title and we have the text. So this is also the discovery and illustration section. We have the section title and we have the section text. So amazing. This is also image gallery. sounds so interesting. So we have the first image and the second image. This is also image. Let's look at what's happening here. So we have the more works section, which is the more works title and the more works images. Really amazing. Let's look at what's happening here. So call this a container. I'd rather call this the footer container. And we have a container inside the container, which is really great. And this is also a container. Now let's talk about the last one, which is the mind-blowing one and the one I loved the most. And it is called the add interaction. Let me show you how this really works on Figma. So if you have ever been scared of prototyping, or you feel like prototyping is a lot of work, you just want to do the design, this AI feature will help you to get started and create that amazing prototype which you want. So imagine I want to prototype these pages from landing page to about page to project page to contact page down to case study page. Let's see what this AI tool can do. So one thing you want to make sure you do before using this feature is to make sure that each of your pages are named properly. Like you could see, I call this the case study page. This is the contact page. This is the work page. You could see all the works there. And this naming conventions are also matching with my navigation. And let's see what the AI will do for us. So you want to click out and click on the make actions here. Then you go under this section, which is the design section. Then you click the add interaction. So when you click on the add interaction, it will say select a few top level frames. So I'm going to select this, select the about, select the work, select the contact, and select the case study. And let's say add interaction. So we allow AI to do its thing. It says adding navigation interaction, and let's see what it does. You could see some of these interactions being added quickly. You could see the interactions. Oh, it says it's done. Wow, interesting. Let's look at what this has created. So I'll just hit the shift spacebar, and let me take this to a bigger screen so we'll see what the interaction looks like. So here we have the interaction which Figma has done with the AI. So let me click on works. Wow, interesting. It opens the workspace, the works page. Let's click on about page. Whoa, interesting. It opens the about page. Let's click on the contact page. And interesting, it opens the contact page. Let's go back to the home and see what the home looks like. So click on home. Oh, it's not connected. The home page is not connected, but the about is connected. The works is connected. The contact is connected. What else? Let's go back to the works and see if it connects any of the work page. That's interesting. So this work page, once you click on this very work page, you see it connects it to the work page. That's really interesting what AI can do. So guys, this is the mind-blowing feature which I love very well, this interaction. For the AI to be able to understand how to interact your various design screens together is mind-blowing. Now is your turn. Let me know which of these features which I have shared is mind-blowing to you and you love the most. I'll be in the comment section. I will make sure I read every of your comments. Don't forget to turn off the notification bell for the next video that is coming next week. I make a post every week, and I will see you in the next video. And bye.